Hi, this video aims to help people who have never solved Rubik's Cube to solve it. If you apply it, you can solve puzzles with different C. For those who want to arrange because it is good for memorization, the Popo method that I saw of is recommended. I will explain while turning. This Rubik's Cube has three colors reversed in two places, white, blue, red, and white, blue, orange. Repeat this for movement again, flipping right, up, right back, to flip, white, blue, red, then the direction of white. Blue and red will be aligned, looking from the aligned state. Right, top, return, right, return, top, again. White, blue, red is rotating. It looks like it is collapsing when you look up. But if you move in the opposite direction, it will return to the original. Up, right, rotate, up, low, right, again. It's back to normal. White, blue, red is back to. But what happened? If I rotate white, blue, red and rotate it downwards and bring white, blue, orange to the original, I will turn. What happens to the collapsed top? Up, right, rotate up, return right. Again, the top has returned to the original. The second stage has also returned to. Put the bottom back. There are two changed places. White, blue, red and white, blue, orange. Explain why there can be only two places that change. The rotation group is divided into two. The first is 8 rotation inter white, blue, red is inverted. The second one rotation to move white, blue, orange. These two groups, if you just rotate it, it will move a lot, so I will put it back. When returning first turn the first 8 hand to change, then turn the bottom one of the second. The only thing that changes is the parts affected by these two rotations. 7 places are affected by the first rotation. If you divide it into 3 stages, the first stage is 1, only white, blue, red. Considering the second stage, it is only where there was bluish red, where yellow red comes. There are 5 changes in the third row. Considering the second rotation, all 8 positions have changed in the first stage. The second stage is 0 pieces. The third stage is also 0. When the two are checked against each other, the only overlapping area is white, blue and red. In the first step, white, red is lifted up, but the result of rotation is not moving. The important thing is not to rotate it, but to move it as a result of rotation. When you write a sentence, it looks like this. One group, two group, minus one group, minus two group. The place just changes when your turn is only the place where the result of one and two overlap. Let's use these two lines. The parts that are far apart align the white, blue, red, and yellow, green, orange. When you turn the correct answer, rotate yellow, green, orange. First to blink it closer. Now turn it aligned the same way as before. It seems the white will collapse because it is on top. But if you move in the opposite direction, it will return to the original, the place the change in the place where one and two overlap. Turning this clockwise is the third rotation that is needed. So the white that comes above does not change. As you rotate first move the left side closer by two rotations. Then turn one group to two group minus one group to turn minus two groups. Bring it back to its original position. Now we have two rotations. By using this rule, you can arrange other types of 3D puzzles by narrowing the place where one group and two groups overlap to only one piece. Next, I will explain the structure of Rubik's Cube. Rubik's Cube can be moved with three types of parts. 1 color, 2 color, 3 color. The position of the 1 color feature does not move. If the upside of white is yellow, no matter how many times it is turned, the upside of white does not move. It's yellow. Next is 2 colors. 2 colors are not mixed with 3 colors. No matter how many times you turn it, it stays in a 2 color position. The last 3 colors are not mixed with the 2 colors and are all within the 3 color position. Next is the correct position. I want to align this white, blue, red, but there is only one correct place. Only here, slided by solid white, blue, and red. If you put this between orange, there are not orange in the three colors, so it's not here. Next, we will invert the two colors. The idea is the same as the three colors. Only one place where one group and two groups overlap. From now on, I will flip blue, red, and blue, orange. I will introduce the simple one first. Raise two pieces to the right. turn. A bird to drop to peace. To the right, the return. To the top, return. Three times. Then, red and blue are reversed. The second row has not moved. Expect blue and red.The first and third tiers have moved. As the rotation of two groups, turn the second stage and bring the blue-orange. And report. One group, three more times. The top returns to the original and the second stage blue-orange is invert. With this, you can invert only two places of blue, red, and blue, orange. The reason why I'm going back is because I've gone around one. If you turn the same movement all the way back,This section is designed to return to normal after 6 times. It doesn't matter if you change it to the same state as before spinning, so you don't have to change it back to minus. Repeat the rotation of 3 colors 6 times.To return, you can line them by turning them like this. Next, I will show you how to arrange. I will invert yellow, blue, and yellow, green. First of all, let's decide that the two groups will rotate the middle and bring yellow, green.In that case, thinking in one group is if you manage to flip the yellow-blue colors and return to the original, consider a procedure that does not move the middle row. Both ends can be moved, so you can put them back together as they do not overlap with the two groups. As you turn first try to invert yellow blue front right, this will invert. But there is a problem with this. The yellow green positional relationship. It was straight, but it'sBent. If you push the front side to avoid it, next move green, yellow. This move blue, yellow up, now it's straight. Next turn the front. This is because white, blue has moved. Bring it back.And turn up this complete one group. Looking at the center, it's okay because it hasn't changed. Expect for yellow and blue. Rotate the middle into groups and bring yellow green. Then I will put it back in a minus two group. Top.Front, right, top, front. At the end, turn the minus two group. Middle, this completes the 2-point inversion. I also do this when I'm next to each other. As a preparation, I will move yellow red to yellow green.This I will continue the same steps. When you turn it, You should return it to the original one, and it will be ready. Please be careful not to be confused because the center is not moved, even if the left and right sides are broken.Next, I will explain the movement. One group is right, up, right return, up, return. Two groups are rotation down, minus two group, then minus one group. It has moved two, three, place. White, blue, orange, white, blue, red.Yellow, blue, orange. I will explain. To move place three plants in the place where one and two overlap. First, the white, blue, and red cubes that are in the position where one and two overlap. The yellow.Blue and red cubes where the second one overlaps in the group of steps. It is a white, blue, orange cube where the third one comes in a position where two groups overlap. No new cubes come in one group when flipping.The cube at the position where the first group and the second group overlap is only reversed. It means the yellow, blue, red has not appeared. That is different. It is important to move only one place where the first groupand the second group, the overlapped. Let's do this time. Instead of white, blue, orange, yellow, green, orange is moving. So as a preparation, I will rotate the left and bring it to the white, blue, orange place. Rotate.The same steps in this state. Right, top, right back, back up, turn two groups and turn minus one. After finish, rotate left to return it. And now you can move in three places. Next is the movement of two colors.The idea is the same as the three colors. Right, top, right back, top up, two groups in the middle. Now turn the minus one group and turn the minus two. We have moved to three locations, blue, red, yellow, green, and blue, orange. If you take a closer look,The place where first group and second group are blue and red. So it is blue and red that are in overlapping positions. And the yellow green that comes in one group of procedures. The last is blue orange which move in twogroups. Let's arrange this time. Three place. Yellow, orange, yellow, green, and blue, red are moving. Rotate the yellow, green on the left to the second stage to prepare. In this state, ターン1グループ、ターン2グループス、マイナス1グループ、ターンマイナス2グループス、This complete, which this you can arrange, Rubik Cube. We will actually arrange it the easiest way to align is to align parts.So I will align the positions of the two colors first. Here is the application. I will explain how to solve puzzles of different shapes. First, Megaminx, which is almost the same as the Rubik's Cube. The position of one color does not change. You can also invert the three colors like this. The way of moving the two colors is to raise the left and right, rotate the front, the return, the left and right. Then only one place has changed at the top. In this state, rotate the top once and return to the original. Release the left, the right to rotate the front. Roll the left and right, rotate the top. With this, you can move three places. In this way, it is possible to hollow out by releasing the left and right sides. At the end, I will arrange like this. Next is a picture puzzle. Thinking in the picture puzzle is to match the direction of one color. At this time, use the deviation of the cycle, the greatest common divisor. This procedure moves the two colors in three places and rotates the right one 19 degrees. Considering the gap, the two colors are three places. So if you turn it three times, it will return. If you turn one color four times, it will return to its original state. I use this because it is three times and four times from the state that the two colors are aligned. Turn it three times, then the two colors will return to their original colors and then one color will be ready. You can arrange it like this. This completes the picture puzzle. Next, 3x3x9. This has the limitation of aligning by rotating 180 degrees because it cannot be moved at 19 degrees. In other words, if you find the procedure, you can arrange it. The way to look is to repeat 4 to 6 times. For example, if you turn this Rubik's Cube 4 times 6 times, it will return to its original state. After turning it 3 times, stop it and look at the first and second tiers. The second tier has returned to its original state. So even if you shift the row 2 steps back to the original, you can move only 3 colors. If you look closely, 2 colors go through 3 places. Yellow green, yellow red, blue red. Looking at the 3 colors, we are moving to place. White, blue, red, yellow, blue, red. The back is the same. So if you turn a multiple of 2, the 3 colors positions will return. Multiple of 3 are variable. in three color positions. If you repeat it like this, you will find that you feel good. Turn the two color exchange in the procedure of 3x3x9. Light up, light up, light up twice, light up twice. I will move this a lot, so I will do this again. Now you can move only one color. If you use this switch 3x3x9, you can move one color. You can also use this like this. Next, I will explain Pari. This is often used as an expression of a condition that 3x3x3 can't do. It's academically different, so I've divided it into two, temporary and real. It can be temporary solved by rotation, but the real thing can be fit only by dissemble. I will explain the provisional pari. If you look at 3x3x9, it looks like one color is offset in only two places. It seems that the three exchange mentioned above won't be complete, but it's okay because the sum parts are underneath. Upper red and lower red, which can be moved to the same position. So move the lower red up. So then the red in the front moves to the back, and the red in the back moves to the right. The blue on the right will come to you. With this, you can align all three places. Then, if you do two color alignment, right, top, right, top, right, you can squeeze the bottom row to only one place. The two groups can move three places by moving down one tile, the them returning. If the positions are aligned, the orientation will be automatically aligned. Next is the cube and master cube. This is also the sum and shift. It is that the overlapping part is in one place. If you look at this line three times, right, left, right, only orange is coming. So with this you can move three places of one color. Even if it shifts, the shift is returns to the original. If you don't have enough, try again. If you just repeat it, you can move the middle color like this. Next is the void cube. Sometimes this is not the case, only is two places. This happens when the position of one color is different. In the normal Rubik cube, there is one color and the position is flipped. The void cube don't have that. As an alignment method, shift on sideways. If you exchange two colors with this, you will have it. This is because the three parts that are white, they are aligned, affect each other. So a void cube that has lost the mark of one color may look like this. Looking at this state, it seems that the direction is turned over, but this is only the position is different. If the position is correct, the direction will be aligned. It seems that there are only two shifts, but this is because the relationship which the position of one color is bad. If you look at 3x, it is in this state. Three colors are two. It means that there three are repeating one color, and wherever you are, they look the same. It can be aligned by lowering it in and moving it. If you compare it with a picture puzzle, the direction of one color has healed. After that, I will repair the parts using the 3-point exchange. You can solve 5x and 7x in the same way. I don't have 6x. This is one the top right, this is it. Pesta octahedron can be folded out. By 2x2 can be solved if you think of it as a 3x3x3 three color blocks. Pyraminx is recommended as a first to self-solve. Mirror blocks are different in size. Since the shape of one color is the same, it is not necessary to match the direction. Since this is 3x3x3, you can align it like the Rubik's Cube. I will explain the movement of two colors pass in two place and the movement of three colors pass in two place. I will use two palm. I have all one side. Red yellow and blue yellow are exchanged. Two colors yellow green red and yellow blue red. For replacements, which two, three colors. I will explain why this is possible. This is also actually exchanged in three places. If you break down this procedure, rotate one group, the place on the right are yellow, red, and yellow, red, green.Next, two groups roll right to the place that changes. First of all, yellow, red, and yellow, red, green that come in step one, where there are yellow, green, and yellow, blue, red. White, blue, red, and red, blue come in two steps, and the original yellow, blue, and yellow, red, blue here. There are two moves. Turn one group, two groups. Minus turn one group, minus two group. This for example. This is the third stage, Red, blue is the second stage. The second cube is moving. White, blue, red is the first cube.If you look at yellow, blue, and third tiers, what happens if I try to do all this in the third tier? As you go, to make it all in the third tier, in a place to move in two groups, the third tier should have come.There is a second stage and a first stage. The third stage comes, changing place. Get ready. Raise the right one. I placed the third stage in the first stage and the second stage. Turn the top one because the second and third tiers will come where one and two.Overlap. The place where one group and two groups overlap can also be set to the third stage only. Turn one group in this state. There are two places to move in the right column. Next, turn two groups. Minus one group, minus two group.And return the prepared one. As a result of turning yellow, green, orange, we can exchange yellow, orange, yellow, blue, orange, yellow, red, yellow, green, red. The place to move is to the left of the result of the preparation.So actually J-PALM is not a two-point exchange. Turn one group. Somewhere else. If you subtract minus one group and subtract minus two group. As a result of this graphs, third and third tier, second and first stage. I managed to change this bottom to the third stage.That's way J-PALM is using. Finally, I will introduce the procedure of 3x3x3. as a summary of the application. How to find the procedure. Try various 4-6 rotations. If you can't find it, simply repeat step 4-6 to search for parts. When arranging, think about the order of arranging the parts. If you still don't have the last few locations, try disassembling then rearranging because of the possibility of parity. Thank you for watching until the end.